Okay, so we're going to help Amy get ready for her date with Patrick. First, we're going to start off with hair. Then we're going to take Tresemme's heat protectant spray and spray it evenly throughout her hair. The reason why you want to do this is so you can avoid getting split ends and damaging your hair. Then we're going to clip the top half of her head and split the bottom half into sections. With the straightener, I'm just curling Amy's hair by curling it away from her face, then pulling the straightener downward. Remember, curling your hair takes practice, so be patient when you're curling your hair. With a big clip, you want to gather the curled hair, then release the top half of the first section. I like to separate the hair so that you do not miss any pieces. After that, I'm brushing her curls to give her hair a beachy waves look so that her curls do not look too structured. Now we're going to sweep her hair to the side and take bobby pins to hold it into place. I absolutely love this hairstyle. I've done it for several occasions, a debut, New Year's, and birthday parties. I definitely recommend this for any event because it looks simple, classy, and it's very fast to do. Just make sure it's secure and use flexible hold hairspray.
So we're gonna start off with this e.l.f. face primer to help her makeup stay, and it controls her oil. And then I asked her to put on some lip balm to moisturize those kissing lips, girl! With this Sonia Kashuk concealer palette, I'm just covering up any redness around her face and some imperfections, and then taking the lighter shade, I'm using it to do a triangle shape under her eyes, and it really brightens up that area, and it's kind of like how Kim Kardashian does her makeup, so I think that looks really nice. Here I'm using the Maybelline Superstay Makeup 24 Hour Foundation, and her shade is in nude. With that, I use the Sigma F80 brush and just buff that all over her face. And then I use Bare Minerals Mineral Veil just to set her liquid foundation so it doesn't budge. With an angled brush, I used shade number 8 from the Sonia Kashuk Ion Neutral Eyeshadow Palette, and I just used that to define her eyebrows and fill them in to make them look fuller because she doesn't really have dark brows, so this really helps frame her eyes. And I took a spoolie just to comb the powder through her brows. From this Greetings from Cabana Glamma, I used this Hoola bronzer from Benefit, and I used that to contour her cheekbones and give some warmth to her face. And for blush, I used Bare Minerals Powder Blush in the shade Vintage Peach, and this is super pretty. It has some micro glitters, and it just gives a really nice glow to the face. Here I used Urban Decay's Eyeshadow Primer Potion, and this will help her eyeshadow last long, and it intensifies the pigment of your eyeshadow, and it keeps them from creasing throughout the whole day. From Shaney Cosmetics, I used this really pale peachy eyeshadow, and it's matte all over Amy's lids, and this will just be a base for the next shadow I'm going to use. From Urban Decay's Naked palette, I use the shade Naked with a Sigma blending brush, and I just blended that into her crease, and that creates more dimension to her eyes. And I also brought that color to her outer corner to give more dimension as well. Then I took this pinky shimmery color and I put it on the outer corner of Amy's lids and just on the outer corner to create depth, and it's going to look like a little sunset on her eyes in a couple clips ahead, but yeah, it's really shimmery and it's really pretty. And also from Shaney Cosmetics, I use this orangey gold color and I just put that on the center of her lids and it blends really nice with the pink color we just put on. And yeah. From Smashbox, I use this Fusion Cream Eyeliner and I just use the brown liner and I just line the top. I'm using brown liner on her instead of black so that it looks less harsh and brown gives a softer look. I also use the same brown liner on her lower lash line on the outer third of her eye. Finish off the eyes with a lengthening mascara. Here I'm using the Sephora Full Action Mascara in black on both top and lower lashes. To complete her makeup, I used a pale pinky nude color from Shaney Cosmetics on her lips with a lip brush from Crown Brush. And I'm so jealous of Amy's lips. Look how full they are. Oh my gosh.
So this is the completed look for Amy's Valentine's date with Patrick. The cardigan is from Forever 21 with a flowy floral paisley dress from Wet Seal and brown leather wedges from Target. Amy is ready for her date.
She was right next to me and I was like,
other thing that I got, I don't know how to pronounce this, but Nami's or whatever, Beauty Center. What was that?
So then Karen's done with the blush.
Okay, eat her.
Eat.
No.
What's that? Your boyfriend, man.
I know.